Hello students, today we have started with another physiological phenomenon of living organisms of chapter 6 and that is osmosis arthat obhisravan. In previous class you got a clear idea about diffusion, but osmosis is totally different from diffusion as because here are the role of semi-permeable, rather good to say selectively permeable membrane is very important. In this case, two different solutions of different concentrations are present at both sides of this kind of membrane, like cell membrane, through which all this process is done. Now look at page number 215. Here are some examples of osmosis with figure, from which you can get a clear idea about that. Now a question may arise in your mind that what is osmosis? Then you have to go to the next page. At page number 216 above, you shall get the definition of osmosis, which is written by Redding. Now I also tell you the definition, and that is, osmosis is a process by which molecules of a solvent tends to pass through a semi-permeable membrane from a less concentrated solution into a more concentrated one. I repeat, osmosis is a process by which molecules of a solvent tend to pass through a semi-permeable membrane from a less concentrated solution to a more concentrated one. Next, we concentrate on osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure is defined as the pressure that must be applied to the solution side to stop fluid movement when a semi-permeable membrane separates a solution from pure water. If you read page number 216 carefully, then you can get a clear idea about it. Next, you look at the below of page number 216, where isotonic, hypertonic and hypotonic solutions are present. Now a question may arise that what are these? So I explain it. In comparing two solutions of unequal solute concentration, the solution with the higher solute concentration is hypertonic and the solution with the lower solute concentration is hypotonic. And finally, the solutions of equal solute concentration are isotonic. Next, page number 217. Here is a very important topic, and that is the importance of osmosis in living organisms. So, just read it carefully. Next topic is germination, arthat onkurodgom. At page number 218 below, the definition and types, that is the epigeal and hypogeal germination, are stated very clearly. So just read it. Next, page number 219. There are some important factors, arthat shorto, which facilitate the germination process, and there are mainly sunlight, temperature, humidity of weather, speed of wind, etc. At page number 219 and 220, there are some experiments related to germination, its type, its factors, etc. You may try this at home. At page number 221, there are some relations in between germination and the two important physical processes of living organism, that is diffusion and osmosis. The main thing is that osmosis and diffusion mainly help to maintain the various factors of germination like temperature, water concentration in seed, etc. So, we may explain it in this way that osmosis and diffusion both have a great contribution in case of germination. Next, at page number 222 to 226, there are some importance of diffusion and osmosis in relation to water concentration in living organisms, especially in human body. When our body needs to recover from a diarrheal illness, that is, our body feels a lack of water, then we have to need ORS, that is oral rehydration solution. Just look at page number 224 to get clear idea about that. Next, page number 225 and 226. There are two incidents of transferring a fish from marine to freshwater or vice versa. I think you may understand that there is a concentration difference of salt water is occurred due to osmosis. So try to answer these two questions at your home. I mean, it's your homework. So students, that's all for today. Next day I shall come with a new chapter, that is chapter 7. Till then, take care. Bye.